here we have a Bluetooth speaker, Bang Olufsen, and this is the model of this speaker is Beosound Explore, which is having an issue about the power and also the audio. I'm going to test. You heard that distorted sound, and this speaker is connected to my charger, and when I play the music and I remove the charger, the unit shut down, the speaker shut down. Let me check again. So this is the symptoms of the speaker playing. Sorry. Distorted sound, and when I removed the charger, unit turned off. Now I'm going to check what is the problem or what is the faulty part that we need to replace. And to disassemble this, we need to remove the cover, and I need, where is my lifter? Okay, I need this rubber suction to pull up the cover. Actually, this one is rubberized, and now I'm going to use my hot air, and I set it to 250, the temperature 250. I need to heat this up because this rubber is on top of the, what you call this, the panel attached to the plastic where it has adhesive. So I need to heat it up to remove that, or to easily remove this rubber panel. Okay, let us start. Do not apply excessive heat on this part. Actually, this is rubberized, no, so it doesn't matter, but you know, overheat, if you apply over temperature on the rubber, it will deform. So you have to control the temperature. And as I said, I'm using, my settings is 250, and you have to peel. Okay, it's hot now. Alright, so now it's ready. I'm going to use this to lift this up. Okay, you see that it's moving. Oh. So once the rubber is moved away like that, it has bubble. We need to, what you call this, we need a flat screw or something. Let me check if I have here. We need this or any flat object. To lift this up. Sorry. Okay. Alright, so here it is. And the rubber is out, so it has adhesive, and this adhesive, if you apply heat, the adhesive is easily to detach. Now that we already removed the cover, the rubber, it has 4 screws. This one is star screw. Let me turn off my hot air. Star screw, and I need star screw here. Hi guys, I found one that fit on this screw, but I'm sorry, I don't know what's the number of this. Four screws are out. Don't worry about the alignment because it has marking on top. Like for example, the play button sign is here and the Bluetooth is here also. So don't worry about it. I will just set aside this sports school and this one. And let us focus on the main unit. Now, let us remove the panel gently. And it has wire attached on the panel, flexible cable. Remember the orientation, the blue side is in front. Let me detach it. Okay, cable is out. So we do have also here screw 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, yes 1, 2, but yes 1, 2. This one is for the handle. Actually guys, this is the first time that I disassemble this model. This is the first time. Okay. And I don't know what is the structure inside. Let me remove this top. Oh no. So this one. Oh yes. Okay, handle is out. And then we can remove now the shell. Wow. So nice. Shell is aluminum. And it has a speaker here. Also here. I don't know if this speaker is active and this one is passive, I don't know. And it has screw over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think the same size. Yes, the same size. So, yes, I need to remove these screws to get access inside. Let me use my adapter. So my screwdriver is sliding. So this screw has spacer. Plastic, you see that? My screwdriver is sliding, so I need to hold this. Oh my god, sorry. I don't have time to purchase a new screwdriver. Maybe the next day I will buy one. The same size, no? All screws the same size. I mean the groove is the same. And we have remaining screw here. And all screw are out. Now remember the orientation here. So it has arrow, no, on the side here hub. And let us remove this gently. Okay, gently. And I saw the wire. Okay, so it has wire here. I'm gonna detach it. The same wire on the panel and also here. And it is easy to detach. I think this is the amplifier board, or also the main board is here. I'm gonna set this aside. So now we have access on the, maybe this is the battery. I think yes, battery is here. So it has 4 screws and the size is the same. Wow, same size. Yes. And 4 screws are out. 4 screws are out. Next, I need to remove this. You see this arrow? So it's pointing here also. The same facing. Okay. Wow. So battery is out and the two speaker is both active. Wow, really nice. So I'm going to keep this aside and let us focus on the battery. And we'll see what is the battery, what is the type of battery that this unit uses. Okay. So this is not the ordinary battery that I usually see from the Bluetooth speaker. It has clip, no? 1, 2, 3, 4. And yes, wow. Yes, this battery is different. And let me see. Okay, shell is out. Let me see the specs of this battery here. Maybe here. So the battery is 7.4 volts. Maximum charge voltage is 8.4 volts. Okay. 8.4 or 7.4. We already see the specs and now I'm going to check the volts. Let me check the volts. You see the wire, it has red and black. So maybe that is the positive black, red, and the negative is black. I'm going to use my digital tester to measure the volts. I'm going to set to DC. And this is the negative. And this is the positive. So we do not have volts here, nothing. And let me confirm if the orientation of the wire is correct. Yes, this is the black side and this is the red side, and we are not getting any volts here. Let me double check again. Nothing, no volts. Now let us see if there is a BMS on this battery. I'm sure it has, because we have here 3, 4, 5 wires. Okay, so BMS is now visible. Okay guys, so this is the BMS of this speaker. And let me check the bolts. Positive is here. And negative is here. And this one negative B1 negative, B2 positive, and B1 positive. So let me check first here, positive and negative. So we have here 2.7 volts. How about here? No? Here? No? 2.7, and it has, I think this one is a fusible resistor. Let's check. We have 2.7, and on this side we also have 2.7 volts, but the volts, the rated volts of this BMS is 7.4. let us check more. I need to see the connection of the cell. Okay, so Okay guys, these two cells are parallel and connection, and these two cells also are parallel and connection, meaning this one, this terminal, and the other cell terminal is connected to each other. So this is the positive and this is the negative, and connected this negative B2 is connected to B1 positive. So the connection here is series. So start from B1 negative and B1 positive connected to the B2 negative, and the final output volts is here. Okay, so let me check this if there is a volts. This is the negative, this is the positive. So we do have here 1.6 volts, at least we have 1.6 volts. And here we have 1.1, that's why we get the total of 2.7 volts. So this volts is really, you know, low, because the rated volts here is 7.4 volts and the full charge volts is 8.4 volts. But I'd like to check what is the IC using, IC controller. Let me pause the camera. I need to see the part number of the controller. I think this one is BQ40Z, not 7. BQ40Z50. Okay, so I need to check this IC if it is working well, and actually I have special tools for that to see if the BMS is okay or not. At this time I'm not going to show this to you. Maybe in future I am going to share it here, but for now I need to see the connection, the data, and I can see here it has P-1. This one is negative. I need the connection for data negative, and I think this one is serial clock and this one is serial data, C and D. So I need the connection, these three important connection, to see what is happening on this BMS. I already had the wire that has marking. This one BSS for the negative, and black is for the serial data, and yellow is for the serial clock. And here the same, yellow is serial clock. The only difference is this one blue, while mine is black. So I'm going to connect first the serial clock to yellow. So yellow is here, serial clock, and then serial data next. Serial data is blue. Where is blue? So next to yellow is blue, and next is black, which is ground, BSS. I'm sorry guys, you didn't see it. As I mentioned, I have battery checker, but right now I cannot share it with you. This is the, I have here special tools that can read the status of the BMS. Okay, let me see. Okay, BMS is not detecting through my computer just because it requires supply. So we need to apply supply. Since this BMS doesn't have output, so it cannot be read by my computer. So I need to apply supply. Positive is here and negative is here. So it's difficult to solder on that part. So what I'm going to do, I have wire ready. this one is positive and the other one is negative. So I'm going to insert this to positive. Positive is already connected and negative is here. I don't know if okay, I will just install here. Let me see if it is fits in. No, it's glued. So at this time I'm gonna solder the negative directly to the board. Negative is already soldered. And let me double check. I'm going to show this to you. This is the negative, this is the positive. Let us confirm if it is really no bolts coming out on that BMS. But since we already checked before, let me confirm before it has no bolts. So nothing. But when I pointed here, it has 2.7 volts. Meaning the our system here of the BMS is not booting or not running. There is our it has problem. Okay, so now I'm going to use two batteries. This is the positive. Negative is here. I'm doing this just to detect the BMS through to my computer. Okay, so let me check on my PC. Sorry guys, no, at this time I cannot show it to you. Okay, so I found it. Yes, I found it. The battery, I cannot sorry, it's difficult to show it to you. I don't have another camera, that's why I'm waiting for my camera to arrive. This one is actually not a camera, video switcher. Don't worry, I will share it to you later. Our BMS is detected through to my computer, and yes, I'm using special tools connected to my computer. And next, I will just see what is happening. What's the part number of that? BQ said. Ah, sorry, the part number is BQ40Z50. BQ40Z50. Okay guys, based on the application, this battery BMS has a permanent fail that we need to clear to work again the battery normally. Okay guys, I already cleared the PF or permanent fail, and we'll check the bolts. Before we are not getting correct bolts here, let me check. Wow, yes, we now have here 6.7 volts and here 3.3 volts. Before I think on this side is 1.2 and on this side is 2 point something or 1.5, I don't know. So we do have here 3.3 volts, and here 3.3, and here is 6.7 volts. After clearing the fault of this BMS, the battery now is giving the correct volts, and I need to shut down this. Okay, before that I'm gonna show it to you, because this BMS can be shut down. As you can see, I have battery here that I connected, so because before it doesn't have any output, I will just disconnect the battery and let us see the bolts again. This is the negative and this is the positive, and yes, we have 6.7 volts, and nearest to the 7.4, and maybe I think this battery is drained, so that's why we need to charge battery. And here we have 3.3 volts. Okay, I'm going to shut it off through the application. I will show it to you how I shut it off the bolts. At this time again guys, I cannot show it to you really because it's difficult. And now I'm going to shut down this one. You see, I'm connected to my tester through this wire. I'm going to shut down. I'm gonna initiate now the shutdown. Shutdown. Yes, it shuts off. See that, guys? The reading is zero. And let me assemble this and let us install it back to the unit and we'll see. Wow, really nice. So nice. Let me remove this wire, the negative. So I need the markings in the future here. The yellow is for the serial clock and blue is for the serial data and black is for the BSS. And next, here. Sorry guys, I'm focused only on my blog. I forgot what is the orientation of this. I don't know, maybe like this. Sorry, like this. Wow, I almost forgot. Okay. Our battery is, I shut it down, so if you press this power, it is not responding because I shut it down through the application. To wake up the battery, I need to connect the charger, of course. Charger. Now we have the lights, solid white. Solid white and, well, off. Let me on. Wow. So let us play music. So it's shutting down, I don't know. Maybe Lobot or something. So it's charging. But let me remove this charger before I am not getting any power when I turn it on. Now we have power. Before it doesn't have power, but it's shutting down. Maybe it's a battery low. But okay, I'm gonna charge it. So need to connect through smartphone on. Yeah, it shows here and then shuts off. Okay, let us wait more time. Ah, yeah, yes, 3%. That's why it's charging 3%. Okay, so I'm going to wait until it become full charge and I will gonna show it to you if our problem is solved or not. Okay guys, so I don't remember the time, but I think this one is almost 1 hour. Let me check. And yes, wow, 22%. Wow guys, really nice. And our speaker is not shutting off. Okay, so let me check the software. Okay, software here. So up to date, no need to update. Now let us check the music before the sound is distorted. Play. Wow. I'm gonna remove the charger. Charger is out. Hold on. Okay guys, we fixed the speaker by doing the clearing the fault on the BMS, and the speaker is working fine now. And hope you learned something on this video. And like what I said, maybe in the future I will share to you what the device that I am using and also the application. But for now, that's all for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and God bless.